surface. As always, listen to your body. If something doesn't feel right, don't want you to do it. But do the class. If there's more advanced movements that we'll make, I'll try to provide a modification for you to do instead. So I'd like to start off with a little bit of a breathing exercise to begin with. A lot of times your breath comes in a different place. Sometimes it's very shallow, sometimes more belly. I want to focus on rib cage breathing, okay? So expanding through the rib cage to the sides and then to the back. So don't think belly's coming out as you're breathing or chest is coming up. Expanding to the sides and into the back. So let's bring your hands to your rib cage. As you're here, just close the eyes and I want you to take a deep inhale, and as you do, I want you to expand the rib cage to the side and into the back ribs. And then exhale through the mouth. And go again. If you didn't quite feel it, try to focus on that movement there. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, deep inhale. Good. Let the eyes come open. So that kind of breath is what I want you to focus on through this class today. So ribs expanding to the sides and into your back, okay? All right, so I want you to just sit in a cross-legged position. I'll come there with you. So let the arms come up. So I want you to reach the arms up to the sky. So as your arms come down, palms facing forwards, I want you to reach energy into the hands as we come all the way down. And then we'll go back up, inhale. Reaching the arms out to the sides, find energy, reaching, 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 and release it out. So I want you to feel like you're lifting through the crown of your head. So lift up tall, find that lift posture, reaching up, and then exhale it down. So let the hands come to the mat. I want you to take your right arm, I'm in a mirror, so I'm taking my left, you're taking your right. I want you to reach up and over, find a stretch through the side body, and bring it back in through center. Inhale. Good. Inhale. So think about that breathing that we did. So as you inhale up and over, I want you to think about all that breath coming into your side ribs. And release. Inhale. Let's take one more on each side. Inhale. Last one. Good. All right, as we're in this place, I want you to take some rotation here. So just hold on to the outside of the leg, rotate, finding a stretch through the back, and then let's go on through the other side. Rotate. So stretching through the whole spine, but I want you to bring it center. I want you to bring your hands to your ribs. And I want you to think of just rotating through the upper back. So it's going to be really, really small. Okay, so as you rotate, I want you to try to activate. You're pulling this way, you're pulling that way at the same time. Good. And bring it through center. Rotate. Try to fight the rotation so you're activating your abdominals, your obliques. Bring it through center. One more on each. So it's really, really small. It's not a big movement. Last one. Bring it through center. So let's go ahead and take it onto the back. As you take it onto your back, I want to focus on a little bit of pelvic rocking here. So bring the hands to the pubic bones. So I want you to feel the upper back heavy into the mat. I want you to feel your tailbones heavy into the mat. And I want you to notice that there's a little space underneath your lumbar spine, your low back. We're going to imprint the spine into the mat. So think about rocking pelvis. If you can imagine the pelvis being a bowl, we're going to try to tip the water out of this bowl towards us, okay? So find the tip of the pelvis, the water flows out, rolling towards us, and then we want to stop it from rolling out, so bring it back level, and slight tilt in the other direction, so you'll feel a little bit of lift of the low back. Let's take an exhale as we tip the bowl towards us, flattening the back into the mat, and then release it out. Let the bowl come level, let it come a little bit towards the opposite direction. And again, couple more, tilt, find that imprint of the back, and then release it out, just released to neutral, we're going to start to take that tilt into your bridge. So if you have issues in the back, I want you to hinge up. So think about keeping your back in just one piece. If you do not, I want you to focus on articulating your spine. So deep inhale, and on your exhale, I want you to start to tilt. Let's roll up into the top of your bridge and just hold there for a moment, okay? So I want you to feel the push from underneath. So glutes are engaged, hamstrings are engaged, extensor muscles of the back are engaged. But I want you to notice the rib cage. Try to keep the rib cage intact. So pull it together, and I want you to feel stretched through hip flexors, okay? So it's a stretch as well. And then let's start to roll back down. Roll, roll, roll. Let the pelvis release out, and then let's go back into it. Flatten out. Roll it up. Pushing the knees forwards as you come up, and then lower it back down. Just waking up the back side of the body, that posterior chain. Let's go back into it. Last two. And release. Let's go one more. Find that roll all the way up to the top, and then slowly let it melt down. Good, releasing out through that pelvis. So let's go into a little bit of abdominal work here, okay? So I want you to pull the right leg in, extend the left leg out, okay? So lifting through head, neck, shoulders if you can, okay? If this is bothersome to the neck, you can do this lying down fully, okay? Otherwise, you're here. And we're going to switch it out. Switch. Good. So if it's too much to extend the legs straight out, you can extend them more towards the ceiling, so going into an upward movement instead. The lower your legs go, the more challenging. So work where you can. We'll take it 8 times. And last one, hold here. So I want to hold in this position. We're going to extend the leg out to the side. So take it slightly out and pull it back through center. So it's not a large movement. Take it out and pull back center. 2 more. So I want you to focus on your pelvis. As you shift that leg out to the side, we're not leaning towards that side. Pelvis is not shifting. Let's go the other side. Extend out to the side and back in. Out to the side and back in. Last two. Out, back in. Last one out, back in. Good. Bring it in. Let the head lower down to the floor. Let those legs reach up to the ceiling. And I want you to let the left leg drop to the floor, pulling the right leg in, finding a stretch here. Then switch. Pull it in. So nice and slow to start. You should focus on that lengthening that's happening through the back side of the leg. Lifting that neck and shoulders if you like. Stretch. And depending on tightness of hamstrings, you might have a slight bend. I usually carry a slight bend in my knee. But I'm still feeling that stretch. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Bring it down with the head lower down onto the mat. So we're going to do a little bit of chest lifting here. So as we go through this, if it bothers the neck too much, come to a tabletop position. You can work on some toe taps. Okay, this movement here. But if you're able to, we're going to go into some chest lifts here. So bring your hands to the back side of the head. And we're not going to lift up through the head. We're lifting up through the abdominals. I want you to focus on your rib cage. Okay, so feel like you find that small little tilt. And I want you to feel your rib cage draw together in the center. We're going to start to lift up into a chest lift, keeping the elbows wide. And lower back down. Exhale, lift. And lower down. I want you to focus as we're doing this, everything drawing in through the center. exhale. So the next time you come up and hold up. Bring the hands behind the thighs. See if you can lift a little bit more here. And then release out. Let's find a static hold. Let's go for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release it back. Let the arms go back. Bring the hands back behind the head. Let's go into a cross over here. So think opposite knee to opposite shoulder. So I want you to lift up, cross, and bring it back down. Let's go other one, other side. So crossing over here. So if you want to advance this movement, pick the legs up into a tabletop position. Okay, so now legs are working against gravity. Your abdominals have to work to hold them up. You could take it into a crisscross. Let the opposite leg extend out as you're crossing over to the knee. Reach. So let's find holds here. Okay, so as you cross it over, hold into the position that you're, so your abdominals are finding the work. Hold and cross it over. Hold. We've got two more. Last one. And lower it down. All right, so we're gonna come back into this tabletop position. I want you to focus on an imprint. So slight tilt of the pelvis. I want you to feel the back flatten out into the mat. Arms reach up to the ceiling. Let's go into a little bit of dead bug here. So right arm's gonna reach out behind you. Left arm's gonna reach away. Let me scoot back because I'm hitting my tower. I've got long legs. All right. Right arm reaches out. Left arm reaches away. You're keeping that back imprinted into the mat and pull it back through center. Let's switch. Left arm reaches out. Right leg reaches away. Pull it back through center. Other side. Inhale out. So you've got that constant press of the abdominals down towards the mat. So it's almost like you're feeling like a magnet's trying to pull your belly button down into that mat. Everything stays connected. We're going for two more. Last one. Good. Knees pull in. Release the knees out. I want you to bring the hands over the head. So let the feet rest for just a moment. So I want to talk about this position that we're in with the hands. So elbows are wide out to the side. I want you to focus on keeping these elbows wide and not allowing your elbows to lift up. So focusing on opening of the chest here too. So a lot of times we're kind of in a crunched over position. Let your chest open up wide. So feel the stretch of the chest muscles. Now let's come back into that tabletop position. So find that slight imprint of the back into the mat, and then let's let the legs fall over to the right. So just a slight, okay? So they're not gonna drop all the way over to the ground. And then I want you to use your obliques, your side abdominals, to pull back through center. And then let's take it to the other side. Left, the legs drop over to the left, and then exhale. So I gotta be extra careful because I'm up on a reformer mat. My table's converted, so I don't wanna roll off to the side, so I can't go over that far. So let's add on to this, you guys. Let's take the legs over. Let's work to extend them long. Let's pull them back into a tabletop and bring them back through center. So take it over on an inhale, exhale, reach, inhale, lower, good, exhale, bring it back through center. So try to find a breath with each movement that you have. Extend, so we're lengthening out that lever. That's where the work gets a little bit more challenging. Let's go one more in each, and then So you know that as we go through progressions, if it's a little bit too much, you don't have to take the progression. It's only an option. Pull it back through center. So let's go into full TikTok this time. So we're going to add head movement with it. So legs are lengthened up towards the ceiling. We're going to let the legs fall over to the right. As they do, the head's going to look towards the left. And then bring it back through center. And then let's switch. And only as far as you can maintain those legs without them fully dropping over to the sides. Use the obliques to pull up and over. Last one. Good. Bring it through center. Excellent job. Arms come down by the sides. Let's let the right leg go down towards the floor. Lift your neck and shoulders if you can. Bring it up to meet and switch. So low abdominals here as you're lowering and lifting the legs. Lower down. Rise up. Lower down. Rise up. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. And lower back down. So last little bit of abdominal work that we're going to do. We're going to go into a little bit of toe taps here. So let's just start with the right leg, okay? Right leg's lifted into that tabletop position. Try to keep the shape of the leg. All we're gonna do is tap it down to the floor and bring it back up. Find a tap. So I want you to focus on obliques, okay? So we're just working one side. So you might wanna pull to this side or maybe this side's working a little bit more. I want you to try to focus on working even on both sides, okay? So feel both sides. And last one, let's take that foot down. Let's go with the left leg. Left leg comes into that tabletop position. Let it tap to the floor. So we're working on progressions a little bit today, okay? So each time we go through these, know that this is a movement that you can come to. If this is enough for you, keep it here as we start to progress up. Inhale down, exhale, lift it up. Let's go last two. Last one, hold that leg up, lift the right leg to meet. So again, find that slight tilt of the pelvis, feel connected to your mats, and then let your right toes tip down, and then bring it back up. Tap and lift. And tap it down and lift. Good. So working a little bit harder, okay? So advancing up. Let's go last two. Now we're gonna advance up one more time. So if that was good for you, keep it there. Otherwise, we're gonna go both legs, tapping down to the floor. Abdominals, pick it up. So don't think speed here. I want you to feel the abdominals working. Let them work. If you'd like to pick up head, neck, and shoulders, you could. It makes you feel a little bit more connected to the abdominals. But again, find that magnet. You're pulling down to that mat. Four more. Deep exhale. Last three. Two. Last one. Good. Let the feet rest down. Extend the legs long, reach the arms long, stretch out through that spine. So you guys, let's go ahead and rise arms up to the ceiling. Let's go into a roll up. If you can't make your way all the way up with legs down, you can bend them. You can hold the backs of the thighs if you need to. So we're going to roll chin to the chest. And it's not going to touch the chest. It's just going to go down towards that direction. And then I want you to pick it up and I want you to reach it forward. Okay, so let's go into a couple of more of those roll downs. So if you feel like you can't get all the way down and bring it all the way back up, just work in this place here. Okay, lowering it down and picking it back up. That's perfectly fine. Otherwise, arms are long, legs are long. Find that nice press through the feet, Start to curl it back, rolling onto the back. Reach the arms behind you, and then bring it back up. So as you come up, you have to almost feel, again, press those legs down into the mat. Make them work. Reach it forwards. As you reach it forwards, I want you to feel like you're pulling the belly button away from your shirt. Roll it up. Reach towards those feet. Pull the belly button away. Stack up through that spine. Go back into it. Shoulders are popping today. Reach it forwards. Good. Arms come up to the ceiling. Lengthen up through the spine. I want you to find your posture. So I want you to reach the right arm a little bit higher. Bring it through center, reach the left arm a little bit higher. So I'm gonna turn towards you, looks like this, okay? Good, so just a little bit of shift through the ribs. You come into a little bit of flexion, find that shift. Good, last one. Excellent job, release it out. So let's go ahead and come into a side lying position from there. Legs will be lengthened all the way out. And then come to whatever position is suitable for you. I'm going to let my head just lie all the way down into my arm. Okay? So legs are extended a little bit more forward. If you need to, you can keep that bottom leg bent for a little bit of support if you need. Otherwise, extend them long. So let's lift up that top leg, okay? So let's just focus on lifts here. I want you to flex the foot, toes facing forwards, okay? So take it as high as it goes. We're gonna go for little lifts today, okay? So as you're lifting, I want you to feel like that lift comes from side glute here, okay? Glute medius, glute minimus. So responsible for that lateral movement that we have, okay? So little pulses here. It's very small. Keep it at the top. Excellent job. So we're going 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Bring it down. Let's go into just a little bit of circles here. Okay, so circle it around. Good. Nice and controlled. So as you circle it around, I want you to focus on trying not to let the body rock forwards and back as you go. And try not to collapse all the way through your side body, okay? So stay lifted. We just got three more in this direction. So you should feel a little bit of fire. Good, last one. Let's reverse that. Opposite direction. Nice, slow, and intentional movements. Good. Let's go for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Excellent job. So I want you to come up to a seated position. As we're in the seated position, so you're propped up, try not to let yourself collapse through your side body. And we're just gonna go through a little lift here. So a little bit of lift, extend, bend, back down. So lift, extend, bend, back down. You don't have to do many of these to feel it, okay? So again, focusing on side glute. Four more. We've got 3, 2, last one. Excellent job. So come up and have a seat. And all I want you to do is, I'm going to make pretend like I'm on the actual floor. So I want you to cross that leg over. Feel a stretch here. And as soon as you cross it over, you'll feel the stretch. Excellent. So before we go to the side, I'm going to take it onto the back. All right, you got it. Or to the stomach, sorry. All right. And as we're in this position, I want you to lift both legs up at the same time. So let's go into that lower and lift. And release it down. So I'm going to have you hold the legs up for a moment. So keep them held up and release. So I'm going to talk through this one the whole way through. So I want you to find those pauses here. So rise it up, hold, and release it down. Rise the legs up, hold, and release them down. Four more just like that with that pause. Rise them up, hold, and release down. Three more. Rise up, hold, and release. Last two. Lift. Good, and release. Last one, rise up, hold, and release. Let the legs come all the way down. So come to a position where your elbows are bent and you're just raised up onto your forearms. Let the low back feel a little bit of stretch here. And we're going to go into both the upper body and the lower body working at the same time. So lower back down. So head is just down towards the floor. I want you to reach the arms out long. So if this is too much on the back, keep your arms to the sides, okay? Otherwise, lengthen them out. So we're going to go into a little bit of swimming here. So think opposite hand to opposite arm, lengthening up. So find your reach of right arm and left leg. You still got your other leg and arm down, and then lower down to the mat. Let's switch. Lift and hold and lower down. So this is the pace we're going. So lift and hold and lower down. So again, intentional movement, switch, lift and hold, switch, switch, switch. Got two more, switch. So let's start making it quicker. Let's go switch, 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 switch. Good, so you see the pace I'm going. Just alternating, lifts, lowers, it lifts, it lowers. Good. Excellent job. So let's finish off here. So if you can maintain this movement with the arms and legs both lifted at the same time, we're gonna swim for about 10 seconds, okay? So I want you to lift both the legs off of the ground, reach the arms out long, little swimmy here. Little swimmies here. Good. 5 seconds. Good. And release it down. So push yourself up into a four-point kneel. So knees are right underneath the hips. Wrists are underneath your shoulders. And just let your feet come flat onto the mat. I want you to rise the spine up to the ceiling. Finding a stretch here through the back. And then release out, let the head lift, let your tail lift. So going into your cat-cow stretch. Exhale, find your lift. Inhale, release it out. Good, one more. Exhale, lift into your cat stretch. And release out from there. Good, coming into a nice neutral back, I want you to send the knees back a little bit. So I want you to find a modified plank shape here, okay? So if booty's kind of lifted, bring the booty down. I want you to have a straight line from your shoulders to your knees. Let your feet just come flat onto the floor, okay? So let the shins rest. I want you to let your elbows bend, let the elbows graze the ribcage, and push yourself away. Lower. Good. And push away. Lower down. And push yourself back up. Lower down. Push. Lower down. Push. Last three. Push. Two. And one. Let the hips sink back. Let your knees go wide. Just coming into a nice rest pose here. And bring it back through center. So let your knees come back underneath the hips. Let your toes curl under now. Okay, so I want to go into a couple of bear planks here. So we're going to work with planks and a little bit of bear planks. today. So I want you to float the knees off of the floor just a couple inches. So back is neutral here. And we're just going to hold. I want you to feel like you have a sling lifting you up towards the ceiling. And your fingers are spread out wide. You're pushing away from that floor. Good. Let the knees rest. Send the hips back. And we'll go back into it. Bring it up. Knees come up. Hold. Good. Knees come down. Hips come back. Good. Back up. Bear plank. Down. Hips back. Up. Knees lift. Down. Child's pose. Back up. Lift. Down. Good. So let's add on some movement to this. Okay? So we're going to go into a plank position to start. But we're going to work kind of in that bear plank movement that we just did. So if you need to stay in modified plank, you can stay in modified plank with this. But you'll send hips back. Curl. Up. Down. Modified plank. Okay? Otherwise, I want you to come into a full-out plank. Let's extend the right leg out. Left leg comes out to knee. So find your solid shape first, okay? So solid plank, and then let's push back into that somewhat of a bear plank. Now your hands, your wrists are underneath the shoulders. So shoulders are working, and then push it forward over the hands. Bring it back, and forward. So try to stick each movement. And forward. Back and forward. Three more. We've got two. Last one. Knees come down. Let the hips go back. So we're going to go into, we're adding on to this movement. Okay, so we're going to go through all those movements, but we're going to add a down dog into it, okay? So let's start with your plank first, okay? So nice solid plank shape. Let's send it into a down dog position. Let the knees come down. Push back into a plank. Stick the movement. Down dog position. Let the heels rest into the floor. Shift the knees down. Push into your plank. Down dog. Bear, plank. Down dog, bear, plank. Three more. Down dog, bear, plank. Last one. Down dog, bear, plank. I'm going to sit down. So we've got to finish the movements on our side body on the other side, okay? So lie on down. So I'm going to come into the same position I was on the other side. So I was lay down on the other side. So legs extended at an angle. Let's go into that lift. So again, remember to flex the foot and think about the heel a little bit higher than the toes. Let's start into that little pulse here. So little lift. And again, try not to collapse through your side body. So you're in that good alignment. And breathe. So I want the fire to start to happen. Again, put your mind here. You gotta put your mind on what muscle you're working. Sorry, I lost my timer. We got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, lower down hip height. Let's go into your circles here. So small little circles. Good, circle it around. Nice and slow. Again, we're not rocking forwards. We're not rocking back. We're staying as still as we possibly can. Let's reverse that. Good, nice and slow. The last three, two, and one. Good. So we propped up onto the side, let the legs bend. And again, don't let yourself collapse. Think about your posture. Let's go into that leg lift, reach, bring it in, lower it down. Lift it, reach it. Good. Try to get it to where your knees are kind of at a 90 degree angle. So you got to get that work to lift, bring it in. Lift, reach. Four more. You should feel a burning burning. Three. Two. Last one. Good. Let it lower down. So come to that seated position. Let your leg cross over the leg that you just worked and find that stretch here. Try to let your hips set down into the mat. Let it release. So let's finish off with a little bit of teaser work today.
Okay.
So again, let's work on progressions. We've been working on progressions today. So let's lower down onto the mat. So I want you to start tabletop position, hands behind the backs of the thighs. Let's chin to the chest. Pull through the backs of the legs as you pull through the upper body and those abdominals. Find your teaser here. So we're in a V-shaped position. It's not full teaser quite yet, but we're going to work our way up to it. Lower back down. Let's go back into it. Curl it up. Good. And hold. And then lower back down. Nice and slow. So last one, utilizing the hands. Good. So we're taking our safety net away. But you know you can keep the hands behind the thighs if you need to. Let your arms reach out. Again, let's go up into your V-sit and lower it back down. Two more. Press the legs together. Come into that V-sit. Stick the movement and lower it back down. Last one. And release it down. So let's let the legs come off the floor. Let's let the arms release out. So we're still going to come into that V-sit that we were just doing, but now we're going to come from that lengthened out position. Okay, so I want you to think, lift head, neck, and shoulders first, then the legs come up. We've got that V-sit, and then try to let everything lower down at the same time. Reach. Let's go back into it. Lift. Stick the movement, and then lower back down. Good. Two more like this. V-sit. Good. And lower back down. Last one. Good. All right. So let's finish off a full teaser. So stick with whatever your body is going to allow you to do today, okay? So don't feel like you have to force into this movement. So I want you to think of upper body coming up first, then lower body. So get the upper body and the abdominals working first, and then start to lift the legs through the abdominals. Okay, so lift. Good teaser. Hold it here for a moment. And then let's lower it back down. Everything meets at the mat at the same time. Let's go back into it. And release. Last one. And release it down. Excellent job. So let's bring your hands back into your ribs. So let's finish off with that breathing that we started with and that we tried to hold all through class today. So I want you to keep your mind on your ribs. Try not to have the breath lying in your chest or in your belly. Your ribs are expanding into the sides and into your back ribs. Okay, deep inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. So I want you to think about all the breath coming into this rib here. Inhale. Good, release. Let's go to the other side. Up and over. Find that expansion into that rib. Inhale. Good. And release it out. So thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed class. And we've been kind of in quarantine these last